गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन. टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट अ टॉपिक ऑफ 9th स्टैंडर्ड, दैट इज अ कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट. दिस इज चैप्टर नंबर 2. स्टूडेंट, इन आवर सिलेबस ओनली 2C and D एक्सरसाइज इन आवर सिलेबस, फर्स्ट टर्म सिलेबस. सो फर्स्ट वी डिस्कस अबाउट कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट. फर्स्ट इज विदाउट यूजिंग फॉर्मूला. स्टूडेंट, वी फाइंड कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट बाय टू मेथड. फर्स्ट इज विदाउट यूजिंग फॉर्मूला एंड सेकेंड इज विथ यूजिंग फॉर्मूला. सो इन दिस चैप्टर, चैप्टर नंबर 2, वी डिस्कस अबाउट विदाउट यूजिंग फॉर्मूला. एंड वट इज विदाउट यूजिंग फॉर्मूला फॉर फाइंडिंग कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट. एवरी वन नो अबाउट फर्स्ट वी आर डिस्कस अबाउट सिंपल इंटरेस्ट इन अर्ली क्लासेस. ओके, पी इज प्रिंसिपल, आर इज रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट, टी इज टाइम पीरियड. If we are talking simple only interest, that means this is simple interest, then simple interest equal to principal into R multiplied T divided by 100. This is the simple interest. Student, if for first year simple interest and compound interest both are same. Okay, for first year simple and compound both are same. So without using formula, what is the without using formula? स्टूडेंट, फॉर फर्स्ट ईयर वी फाइंड सिंपल इंटरेस्ट. दिस इज कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट. फर्स्ट ईयर बोथ आर सेम, सिंपल एंड कंपाउंड. ओके, देन वी फाइंड इंटरेस्ट दिस बाय दिस फॉर्मूला. दिस इज कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट फॉर फर्स्ट ईयर. फॉर सेकेंड ईयर वट विल बी डू फॉर सेकेंड ईयर. स्टूडेंट, पी प्रिंसिपल, आर रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट, टी टाइम पीरियड, एस आई सिंपल इंटरेस्ट फॉर फर्स्ट ईयर. नेक्स्ट आफ्टर दैट वी फाइंड अमाउंट. अमाउंट इज प्रिंसिपल प्लस इंटरेस्ट. ओके, अमाउंट इज प्रिंसिपल प्लस इंटरेस्ट फॉर सेकेंड ईयर. फॉर सेकेंड ईयर अमाउंट इज प्रिंसिपल फॉर सेकेंड ईयर. ओके, दिस कंप्लीट इज प्रिंसिपल फॉर सेकेंड ईयर. दैट मीन्स दिस इज प्रिंसिपल. ओके, लेट वी टेक दिस पीरियड. दिस इज प्रिंसिपल आर सेम एंड टाइम पीरियड ओनली वन ईयर. दिस इज ओनली वन टाइम पीरियड फॉर फर्स्ट ईयर, वन टाइम पीरियड फॉर सेकेंड ईयर ऑल्सो वन, देन डिवाइडेड बाय 100. ओके, दिस इज कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट फॉर सेकेंड ईयर. कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट फॉर सेकेंड ईयर. नेक्स्ट स्टूडेंट, फिर अगेन वी फाइंड प्रिंसिपल प्लस कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट एंड दिस इज अगेन अमाउंट एडेस. लेट दिस इज अगेन अमाउंट एडेस. फॉर थर्ड ईयर वी टेक दिस इज द प्रिंसिपल. We take this is the principal, let principal P dash, this is the principal same as it is. Okay, multiply R multiply time period 1 divided by 100 and this is the compound interest for a third year. Compound interest for a third year. First year, second year, third year, if we add all of these three, then these are total compound interest for third year. Okay, these are total compound interest total for third year. This is only first, this is only for second, and this is only for third. But if we add, this is compound interest for 3 years. Okay, now I take some questions from the exercise, then you understand very well. Now this is question number first from exercise 2C. A sum is invested at compound interest. If interest for two successive years be 5700 and 7410, calculate the rate of interest. Okay, straight, these are the compound interest for successive 2 years. For first year, compound and simple interest both are same. Straight for second year, there will be interest on first year interest also. ओके, फॉर सेकेंड ईयर के लिए फर्स्ट ईयर के ब्याज के ऊपर इंटरेस्ट के ऊपर भी इंटरेस्ट होगा, इसलिए इंटरेस्ट सेकेंड ईयर का हमारा ज़्यादा होगा सेकेंड ईयर के सिंपल इंटरेस्ट से. सो फॉर फाइंडिंग द रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट फर्स्ट वी फाइंड द डिफरेंस बिटवीन टू सक्सेसिव ईयर्स ऑफ कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट. देन डिफरेंस बिटवीन टू सक्सेसिव ईयर्स कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट दैट इज 7410 5700. ओके, दिस इक्वल टू 1710 एंड दिस इज द सिंपल इंटरेस्ट. दिस इज द सिंपल इंटरेस्ट ऑन दिस So this is for this working for principal, and this is simple interest. We have result. We'll take principal. This is 5,700, and rate of interest. Let we find rate of interest and time period only one, because this is first and this is second. This is the difference on a simple interest. Okay. Then according to simple interest formula, principal multiply rate multiply time period 1/100 equal to simple interest. And simple interest is a, this is simple interest for first year simple interest 1710. Then in place of principal 5700 multiply r equal to 171 multiply 100 and r equal to 17110 multiply 100 divided by 57. Okay, 20 cancel out, then 571 5730. Then r equal to 30%, r equal to 30, then r percent equal to 30%. Okay, this is the question number first. Next I will take next question. Next question number 5. Mohit invested rupees 8,000 for 3 years at a certain rate of compounded compound interest. At the end of 1 year, it amounts to 9,440. Calculate first part rate of interest, for second part amount at the end of second year, and in third part the interest in the third year, compound interest in the third year. Okay, student, first we have given, this is principal and this is amount after 1 year. Okay, so we have principal equal to 8,000 rupees. Okay, time period only 1 year. First we take time period only 1 year, and this is amount after 1 year. Then 94540, this rupees amount. And in first part we find the rate of interest. Let r be the rate of interest, r percent, rate percent. Okay. Then if we first part we find simple interest, a simple interest by amount minus principal minus 8,000, then this equal to 1440 rupees. This is the simple interest. 1440 rupees is the simple interest for first year. So what is the simple interest? Simple interest equal to principal multiply r multiply time period 1/100. Simple interest equal to this principal 8,000 r as it is by 100. Okay, then 1440 equal to 80r. Then r equal to 1440 by 80, 0 to 0 cancel, to 4 to 7 to 2 to 36 to 1 to 18, r equal to 18, then r percent equal to 18%. So first part is the rate percent 18%. We use next, for in next part we use the rate of interest 18%. Student, for second question, amount at the end of second year. Okay, we find the amount at the end of second year. Student, first year amount is the principal for second year. Okay, principal for second year. This is the principal for first year. This is the simple interest for first year. And this is the compound interest also for first year. For second year, principal equal to this. First year amount is the principal for second year. And rate of interest equal to same 18%. We find the amount for second year. First we find interest for second year. And this equal to principal multiply rate of interest multiply time period only one, because this is only for second year, only second, first, and this is only for second, and 100. Okay, then interest equal to 0 to 0 cancel, 944 multiply 18 by 10, 3992 divided by 10, and this equal to 1699.2. 1699.2 rupees is the interest for second year. This is the interest for first year. this is the compound interest for second year. But we find the amount at the second year. So amount at the second year, amount is A, amount at the end of second year, then this equal to principal plus interest, and principal is this 9440.0 and 6699.2, then 2, 9, 13 and 1, 6, 4, 10 and 1, 11, 1, 9, 1, 10 and 11. This complete 11,139.2. This is the amount for second year. Okay. Next we find the interest in the third year. Interest in the third year. Student, amount for second year is the principal for third year. Okay. This is the principal for third year. So interest for third year. For third year, interest for third year, principal, and this is principal, multiply rate of interest 18, multiply time period 1 by 100, and we take also 10 for this. Student, we find this complete calculation, and this complete calculation is the interest for third year, and this is the answer for third question. Okay, next I will take next question. The next question number 12. A man owes 10,000 rupees at 10% compound interest at the end of each year. He pay back 20% of amount for that year. How much money is left unpaid just after the second year? How much money unpaid just after the second year? Second year ke baad kitna paisa uska pay karna rehta. Okay. So first, this is the principal. Principal equal to 10,000 rupees, and rate percent equal to 10%. At the end of each year, he pay back 20% of amount. First, we find interest for first year. Interest for first year, principal interest for first year, principal. Multiply rate, time period only 1 by 100, and this equal to 1000 rupees. 1000 rupees is the interest for first year. Amount for first year 10,000 plus 1000, this equal to 11,000 rupees. Okay, and he paid back 20% of the amount in each year. Okay, then he pay first year after first year he pay 20% of amount. That means 11,000 multiplied 20 by 100. Okay, 11 to 22, he pay 2200 rupees. Then unpaid after 1 year equal to 11,000 minus 2200 008 and then 8 and then zero. Okay, 8800 left after 1 year. Okay, and next for second year, this is the principal for second year. Kyun? Kyunki interest sirf bache hue paise pe lagega. Okay, this is the left money after first year, and this is principal for second year. For second year, is principal. So interest for second year principal multiply time period 1, rate of interest 10 by 100, and this equal to 880 rupees interest for second year. Student, this is interest for 1 year. This is greater than this because he pays some money at the end of his first year. Okay, then this is interest for second year. Amount for second year 880 plus 9,680 rupees amount for second year, and he also paid 20% at the end of second year. Then 20 he pay 9680 multiplied 20 by 100. Okay, 8 to 16, 1, 6 to 12, 1, 13, 1, 9 to 18, and 19. This rupees. He paid this rupees. Then left money. Left unpaid. Equal to left unpaid equal to this minus this minus okay 10 minus 6 4 then 7 minus 3 4 then 16 minus 9 then 7 8 minus 1 then 7744 rupees left for unpaid after second year. Today this is the exercise second C, second day also of the same time. You try to solve the question of second A, B also. But if you have any problem, then you send to me so that I will solve your problem. Okay, thank you.